Okay. Welcome. Okay. Hello, class.
Hi.
How are you today?
Good.
Awesome. Okay, so today we're going to learn how to give an oral presentation about the posters we made last week, okay? So, first I'll explain the type of speech that you're going to give. And you all should have interviewed one WW student, okay? So, based off of the interview that you did, you will have created a poster just like mine about that student. And today we're going to learn how to do an informal speech. So, an informal speech means that you can look down at your paper as you give the speech to the class. But you shouldn't have your face in front of the speech the entire time, okay? So if you ever get lost, you can just glance down. And also, during an informal speech, you can do things like ask questions or tell a joke, okay? So an informal speech is casual, and the audience might ask you questions, and you can answer them during your speech, okay? So like I said, you don't have to memorize everything, and you can use note cards if you get lost, okay? So while you give your informal speech, you should make eye contact the whole time with your audience, and you should smile as well, okay? Awesome. All right. So to begin, I'm going to read you my speech, and I'm going to give my presentation, all right? Okay. So, hello everyone. Have you ever wondered what a college student eats? Yeah, me too. Many people believe that because college students are poor and they're busy with schoolwork, that they often don't eat very well. So, I've always wondered if this is really true and if American college students actually eat top ramen every day. So, today, I'm going to tell you about the nutrition of a Western student. I interviewed this student, and his name is August. And August told me about all the things that he likes to eat. So, August is 22 years old, and he's about to graduate from college. He's very active. He likes to run, bike, play baseball, play tennis, and hike every week. So, to interview August, I asked him politely if it was okay. And he said it was okay. Then I asked him about what he eats for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. I also asked him some bonus questions for fun. So, for lunch, August told me he likes to eat a sandwich, yogurt, and fruit. He sounds pretty healthy to me. And for breakfast, August told me he likes to eat pancakes, oatmeal, and eggs. And then finally, for dinner, he told me he likes to eat salmon, corn, and potatoes. So he has pretty healthy eating habits. I also asked August a few more questions about his nutrition. The first question I asked was, "What's your favorite food?" And he said his favorite food was cheese. So here are my bonus questions, and then he said he loves cheese. And it's also one of his snack foods as well. The second question I asked was, "Where do you get all of your food?" And he told me he gets his food at Trader Joe's. So in America, college students and everyone else can get their food at the grocery store, like Trader Joe's. So you have grocery store, and sometimes it's called a supermarket. Or you can grow your food in a garden at home. Or you can go to the local farmers market and buy food from farmers. Or you can order food online and it comes in a box and it's all in a kit, just like this. So the third question I asked was, what do you think the food you eat does for your body? And he said that he eats well, and therefore the food that he gives his body helps him be able to run and bike every day, because that's really important to him. I also learned some fun facts about the foods he eats. So potatoes, which August eats for dinner, were the first vegetable ever grown in space. And salmon, which he eats for dinner, salmon usually have an average of 2,500 eggs. And sometimes they have more. Can you think of how many more eggs salmon might have? So they usually have 2,500. Sometimes they have more. How many do you think they have?
Another thousand.
Another thousand? What do you think, Katie?
5,000.
What about you, Annie?
4,000.
4,000. So they actually have up to 7,000 eggs in one salmon, which is pretty crazy. And then the third bonus question that I asked him was, corn, which he eats for dinner, is produced on every continent in the world except for one continent. Can you guess which one? What do you think, Anne? Which continent do you think corn is not produced on?
Probably Antarctica.
Antarctica, yeah, you're right. So it's a little bit too cold for the corn there. All right. So overall, I think August has a pretty healthy diet for a college student, and I think he gets a lot of nutrition from his food. So thank you for listening and learning with me today, and I hope you enjoyed meeting my friend August. All right, so based off of that, I want you to get into a group, and I've cut up my speech here, and it's all in a different order, and I want you to see if you can remember which order it should go in, okay? So there are 7 parts to my speech, and I want you as a group to put it in order, and we will go over what the order might be. So here we have speech organization. So the first section of my speech started with the hook. Now, do you know what the hook is? No? So the hook is something that grabs the reader in. It's something that's really interesting. So for example, I asked you a question, right? I asked you, have you, pretend like I remember my question. Yeah, I asked you, have you ever wondered what a college student eats? So that got you thinking, kind of have wondered that. Or you could tell a joke. So Katie told a joke earlier in her speech, right? So the hook grabs you in, like when you're fishing, grabs you in and you want to know more. And then the second thing is the introduction. So you have the introduction. Okay, and then the third part of my speech is the background. So what's the background of the person that you interviewed? Or how did you get the interview? How did you talk to the person? How did you treat them? What happened? And then the third or fourth part of the speech is going to be, yeah, so the fourth part of your speech is going to be the interview question and results. So I asked August what he eats, right? So it'd be the interview results. And then the fifth part is bonus questions. So I asked him where he gets his food, what his food does for him. All right, and then the sixth was fun facts. So I told you how many eggs salmon have, and corn's grown everywhere. And then I had my closing, which included an opinion. So I told you that I found out that August actually eats pretty healthy for a college student. So opinion, and I also thanked you for listening. So Anna, thank you. Okay, so based off of all of these, I want you in your group to put them in order, okay? And I'll give you 2 minutes. Okay, you got it all? Perfect. All right. So we will go over the sample phrases to see if you did the functions correctly. So, Katie, can you tell me the first 3 words in the hook?
Hello, everyone. Have you ever wondered?
Yeah. Hello. And then I said, have you ever wondered? So I asked you a question to hook you. And then, Wendy, can you tell me the first few words in the introduction?
Today I'm going to tell.
So I asked you today. And then Anne, can you tell me the first few words in the background?
To interview August.
Right, so to interview August. So I told you how I got the interview, what happened. Right, because in our last few lessons, we learned about how to politely interview people. So this was a really important part of our presentation. Okay, and number 4, Wendy, can you tell me some of the, or the first few words in the interview results?
I asked August a few more questions.
Yes. A few questions. Right, so I asked him what he ate for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So we put breakfast, lunch, dinner. Okay, and then what about the bonus question? Katie, can you tell me the first few words for the bonus questions?
For breakfast, August told me.
Well, maybe not that one. So we already did breakfast, lunch, and dinner, but you have it in the right order. And then you also asked.
I didn't know, so I think it's this one first. Yeah, like for breakfast, and then these are the bonus questions.
Yeah.
For breakfast, August told me.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then I have here.
I asked August a few more questions.
Good job. So I asked a few more questions, right? Okay. And then. All right, perfect. And then I had some fun facts, right? So what did I say for that part? What were the first few words?
I also learned some fun facts about the food he eats. And also,
some fun facts. Great job. All right, and then how about the last part? Wendy, what did I say for the closing?
I think August has a very healthy diet.
Yeah. So I gave my opinion, so I think. And then how did I end my interview? What were those words, Wendy?
Thank you for listening.
Yeah, so thank you for listening. Great job. All right. Perfect. So I think you guys got that. All right. So before we begin the next activity, I just want you to remember that if you're ever confused, you can ask me any of these questions. And I'll pass out this packet for you so that you can follow along and remember some of the phrases to ask questions. And it's on the second page, I think. Yours is the first. You can ask me these questions. So, can you please say that again? How do you spell that? What does that mean? And can you explain that again? All right, so I'm going to read my speech and you are going to fill in the blanks in your packet, okay? Perfect. All right. Have you ever wondered? Hello, everyone. Have you ever wondered? Today I'm going to tell you about. His name is August. August likes to. To interview August, I asked him first question. For breakfast, August told me. For lunch, August told me. And finally, for dinner, August told me. The first question I asked was, the third question I asked was, I also learned some fun facts. I think August. And finally, Thank you for listening. I enjoyed meeting. I hope you enjoyed meeting. All right, did everybody finish? Perfect. How much time do I have?
10 minutes.
Okay, so we will pretend that we went through the answers already and checked them.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So now that we've checked all of the answers, I'd like us to do a think, pair, share, okay? So in your group of three, I want you to answer these questions in your packet. So here on this page, we've got the think, pair, share, and I asked you two questions. So in your group, go ahead and answer those two questions. And you've got a copy of my speech on the front page, if you can't remember, okay? So you can look in the speech. So, were you able to answer the question in your group?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And what did you say? Did I ask any questions in my speech?
Yes.
Yes. Do you remember how many questions I asked?
Two?
Yeah, perfect. Why do you think I asked some of these questions?
To keep the audience
paying
attention.
Yeah, right? So, I was trying to keep my audience engaged. I was trying to hook them in. And I'm also doing an informal speech. So remember I said that I could ask questions during my presentation as well, right? Awesome, great job. Okay. So now we're gonna move on to the next page in your workbook. All right, and so with your partners, I want you to look at this outline of how my speech was constructed. And in each one, I gave you sample phrases of how I started each section of my speech. And in your group, I want you to get together and try to just talk about what you learned about that Western student. So talk about that student. And while you're talking about that student, try to say it in this kind of order, okay? So start with a hook, so maybe ask them a question, and then go to the introduction. Today I'm going to tell you about, so tell them about whoever it is you interviewed. And then give them some background. To interview this person, I had to, what did you have to do? And then interview question results, what did you learn about them? So if you did nutrition, what did you find out that they ate? And if you did physical activity, what did you find out that they do to get some exercise, right? Okay. And then I want to know some of your bonus questions and the fun facts. And the fun facts you should have already done your research for, so you can tell us those too, okay? So get in your groups and just plan your speeches. And pretend that you actually planned your speeches. Okay, so now that you've talked about your speeches and practiced them a little bit, I am going to show you the rubric that you're going to be graded on. So if you can go to the next page. Yes. All right. So as you can see, you've got the rubric here that you're going to be graded on. So you've got your rubric, and these are all the things that I'm going to grade you on. And it's going to be out of 50 points. So you'll have a few days to do your speeches, and then I will just watch you as you go. Perfect. Got it? Do you have any questions about the rubric?
Yeah.
speech now in front of the class. So if you could just come up and show your poster and tell us about the student that you learned about, okay? Okay, awesome.